Good morning, Mimi, and good morning to all your listeners.
All right. Henry, before we get to the business question, I'm very curious. We've always known you as the Chief Technology Officer of the group, and now that you're moving to Union Bank Digital, Union Digital, what happens to the technology officer post? Who's replacing you there, or is it going to be one and the same?
Oh, so we have a great guy taking over the portfolio. It's our Chief Information Officer and Operations Officer, Dennis Umila. So he's been with me for about 6 years, and he's doing a fantastic job.
All right. So now that you're the head of the new Union Digital Bank, I wanted to ask you first if you can help us visualize how the money flows from the employer to the OFW and sent back home to their families here. They are paid in cash there, right? And where do digital banks like you come in? How will it work?
Well, you just described the critical money supply chain that our kababayans in several countries outside the Philippines have to deal with. In particular, in Israel, where we recently went, we saw that they receive cash, they convert it to dollars, and then from dollars moves over to the Philippines, and from dollars converted to peso. So imagine, the World Bank study says the average remittance cost is about 6.3%. Some of our kababayans are paying double that or more than double that. In fact, in Israel, it's at least 16%. So digital banks would be able to cut the friction cost and just do account-to-account transfer. So that's what we've been working on. And not just in Israel. In fact, Mimi, I'd like to share with you, hot off the press, yesterday we had a great event with our kababayans in Hong Kong together with our partner MWell. And, you know, we're excited. We'll go to Singapore. We'll go to Germany. We'll go wherever there's our kababayan working so that we can provide better financial services.
Currently, Henry, how does... So when they convert their salaries into U.S. dollar, how do they send that U.S. dollar back to here, via remittance center still or via banks already?
Mostly remittance centers. So the unfortunate situation of our kababayans is if they were here in the Philippines with the amount of money that they're making, they would easily be able to open an account. And if they open a digital account, it will take you less than 5 minutes. Mm-hmm. In other countries, some are not allowed to open an account and some have to line up for a few hours just to open an account. In fact, there are pictures that I guess my team shared with you. I mean, that's on a Sunday and our OFWs are lining up for hours just to open an account. So the problem there is really access to a bank account outside of the Philippines.
So where do you come in? This Israel venture, are you partnering with remittance centers there or are you allowing Filipinos there to open Union Digital accounts?
Well, it's in the works. Recent events, you know, kind of slowed us down in terms of the situation in Israel, and it's getting better. The vision is by end of this year, we would have partnered with another digital bank in Israel, and it would be digital bank to digital bank. Now, the nice thing about a digital bank is you can bank from your sofa, so you don't have to go out anymore. You do your online KYC, and within minutes, you're able to open the account. So hopefully, within the year, they wouldn't need to handle cash anymore. Their employers would deposit in an Israeli bank, and that bank would be partnered with Union Digital, and you do account-to-account transfer.
Will you be the first local digital bank to be present in Israel?
We're aspiring to be one. We're still working with our government partners and definitely with the counterpart in Israel. And it's not just going to be there. It's going to be a template that we will replicate everywhere we have OFWs.
All right. And you mentioned about this, the friction, the cost friction here. How are you going to be charging Filipinos who will use this Union Digital?
Well, definitely we will be lower than the 6.3% World Bank study. So the business of Union Digital is basically lending. So what we want to do is make our revenue from our ability to lend to the families of the OFW. And that revenue stream will subsidize whatever expense there will be for the cost of transferring money.
All right. Henry, I'm very curious because whenever I talk to OFWs, they always tell us another challenge is during peak season when they send money home through International Remittance Center. The family supposedly can claim the cash here through a partner center. And sometimes during Christmas or enrollment season, the centers here run out of cash. Will that, you know, will partnering with Union Digital spare them from this sort of problem?
Definitely. And it's not just Union Digital doing it. It's basically our regulators. Mm-hmm. You know, with the advent of digital payments, with the BSP pushing for QRPH, we will come closer and closer to the situation where cash will not be needed anymore. It's going to be electronic transfer. And when you have that, money moves more fluidly and more accessible to people. Mm-hmm. So imagine, instead of lining up to a counter, or right now that the economy has opened up, you're now dealing with the traffic, you could just bank with an app. So that's the intention.
So you want to be a lending machine for OFWs and their families here. How do you intend to grow the business model?
Well, the business model in itself is robust. One of the things that we pride ourselves in Union Digital is our underwriting, our ability to identify underserved segments of the financial market and be able to weigh the risk in terms of the lending side. So at the end of the day, we're a business. So we need to be able to figure out how to recover the money that we lend out. And, you know, we're a big user of AI and data science, and we're putting to work all of the technology that we've learned from the parent bank. So Union Digital is a proud, fully owned subsidiary of Union Bank. And the technology that Union Bank have tested and proven to be working are now being deployed in Union Digital.
All right. And let's talk about competition. I imagine it's all about partnerships to be able to compete. One of the major e-wallets here is currently partnered with a Chinese giant that makes them available in South Korea, Japan, Singapore, and Malaysia. Would you say competition in this space is still a blue ocean?
Well, the pie that we need to solve is so huge that everybody is encouraged to partner with one another. I think it will take several years before people can run out of the untapped market. Mm-hmm. So to us, it's not so much as competition. It's about partnering with people with the same vision of financial inclusion. And specifically for the OFW, we will partner with anyone and everyone who would want to address that issue.
Mm-hmm. All right. And what do we know about the remittance industry? Why did you decide to venture into the remittance space, the OFW market? I mean, there are estimates we've got around 10 million Filipinos living overseas. What's the average size of remittances that we know? When is the peak? How frequent do they make these transfers? I imagine many people, you know, can send very small amounts frequently. Yeah. So this will be a volumes game for you?
As I mentioned earlier, Mimi, the remittance space is huge, and the market that it services, the OFW, really require better pricing in that area. Mm-hmm. But again, we're a bank, and our main bread and butter would be lending. So our ability to service them effectively in the remittance rails allows us to gather more information about them, their payment habit, the frequency that they have for sending money, what do they send it for, and that allows us to feed our underwriting engine that targets them for the appropriate loan that they would need. So the margins in the remittance space actually is very small. It's getting more competitive each year. But in contrast to that, the 16% is just too much for an OFW to pay, right? So we can actually solve that, at the same time move our revenue stream to areas where it helps them: lending for education, lending for medical services, lending for their SMEs. So that's how we intend to crack the market.
Henry, before I get to the big picture question, I wanted to complete the visualization of the money flow here. So if the employer in Israel, for example, pays the salary of my salary if I work there, they will simply deposit my salary to my account, correct?
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Which is partnered with Union Digital. And
yes,
when they
right.
transfer the money, so there's the cost of, there will be a transfer cost, correct? which you say will be very competitive. Once the family here encashes that money, do they go to any Union Bank branch and encash the money for free, or will they have to pay to be able to encash, like the e-wallets we have here?
So in that last leg, it will be like cashing out from any of the 7,000 over-the-counter cash-out service providers that we have in Union Bank. Or they can do it electronically. In fact, what I advocate is if you already have an account and we're envisioning the day where you don't have to carry cash anymore, you could just do QR codes. That cuts down a lot of the cost. Because imagine if it's digital, the overhead logistics associated to bringing cash out of the bank, putting it on a counter, people moving to get the cash, and having an inventory of cash actually in one location, that takes a lot of cost. So you eliminate all of that when you do it electronically.
All right. Final question. The last time I spoke to the Union Bank team, they told me that the digital bank was breaking even and hitting milestones with deposits. I know you're hitting 1 year since the launch in July this year. Where are you, and what's the your contribution to the mother bank?
Well, you know, when we talk about how we're doing financially, we're on track to making our income targets within the year. And our contribution to our mother bank, our parent bank, will be modest this year, but enough to set us a stage where in the next coming years we'd be able to contribute more for the overall bank enterprise. Right now we're working closely with the Union Bank because most of our regulatory and governance and making sure that we run as a bank depends on how much oversight our parent bank has. In return, we're half fintech. So we provide the agility in terms of sending and putting new products out there. So it's a good combination where we have a strong parent bank and we have a fintech origin. So that combination in the years to come will redound to more top line for us that we can contribute to the bank.
Given the macro headwinds we're looking at this year, high interest rates are starting to normalize. There's a looming global recession, which will impact OFWs. How bullish are you about the next 6 to 9 months?
I'm very bullish because I think right now things are easing. And domestic inflation is expected to continue this deflation towards the end of this year. And I think with all of that normalizing, it's just the natural reaction now to the economy opening up. A lot more financial services will be needed by our kababayans, and that speaks well for the banking industry.
All right. On that optimistic note, Henry, thank you so much for joining us, and congratulations again.
Thank you very much, and good morning.